Good morning, Cardini Tarje, back with another view. Let's get to it. Today's random Mike Schmidt item of the day. Have his four starting lineup figurine cards. So this was 1988 when starting lineup came out with its first release of figurines. This is the card. They stuck in the back of the inside the box with the player. All the different players were available. They all came with little cards. This is the 89 version, 1989 edition. So you had the figurine, and you had this card right next to it. This one came out in 1995. They had they were still cranking out the starting lineup figurines once in a while, but this one was dedicated to Mike's election to the Hall of Fame. And then they made another release that I care about because this is the Mike Schmidt one, but this is the All Century team. They actually put out a set of figurines highlighting some of the members of the All Century team. And that is Mike's version. And to show you that I collect everything Mike Schmidt, let's go through the starting line of figurines themselves. So here is the first one ever released of Mike Schmidt. Interesting, if you look at the starting lineup figurines back in the day, you'll see that they had about seven or eight different molds. And here's the list of players that they put out on the back. And they would just paint it differently. They would just put different kind of ink, but they'd have the exact same figure for multiple players. And this is the Schmidt one from 1988. Here is your 87 version. Same thing back, or sorry, it's 89, excuse me, but the 89 version. Even for the first few years, they just used multiple molds for the exact same player. So all the people on the back of this one could be found in the same pose in multiple places. And they started going a little bit different. I think by the time this edition came out in 95, they were crafting more and more unique poses rather than just doing, you know, about 10 different molds for everybody that was on there. All right. That was the 1995 Mike's Hall of Fame edition, 1995 one. And then, like I said, the All Century Team version of Mr. Schmidt. And here's several of the different players you could get in that starting lineup All Century Team. They probably are still available for $20 or under, and I don't care who it is, if it's Babe Ruth, Ty Cobb, whoever. You could probably still get them for a very inexpensive price, if you chose. So there you have that. Those are my Mike Schmidt starting lineup cards, along with, just put them down here, along with the actual starting lineup figures still in the boxes. Today's random baseball item of the day. Very simple card, but as a baseball historian, it brings to mind some funny stories. So, 1992, this one might be the 1994 version, the Conlon collection. It features Daffy and Dizzy Dean, you know, Jay, Hannah, sometimes Jerome, Dean, and his brother Paul. And Paul D, quote Daffy Dean, Jay, Hannah, oh, sometimes I've heard him called Jerome Hannah. I don't know what's true. There's so many stories behind these guys. I can never tell what's true. Two of the best stories I heard ever about Dizzy Dean and his brother Daffy, or Paul and Jay Hannah. So the first one is a simple one. Dizzy Dean predicted to start the 1934 season that him and his brother were going to win 45 games. Just, me and Ball, I think we'll win about 45 games and get to the World Series because everybody else will do their part too. Something really arrogant. And darn if he didn't, I do it. I think he won 31 games that year, and Paul won like 17, so they obliterated, but they beat the record handily. Let's put it that way, his prediction. They very well met that prediction. The other great story about Dizzy and Daffy Dean together as brothers is the two of them pitched a doubleheader one year. Yeah, I can't tell you what year. I didn't research it enough to give you all the precise stats. but the story between them is legend. So Dizzy starts the game, the first game, and goes the distance, pitched like a two-hit shutout or something like that. He just dominated the other team. So Paul goes out. He starts the second game, and he throws a no-hitter. So you got the two brothers pitching both ends of a doubleheader, both crush the other team, Paul with a no-hitter. And Dizzy afterwards bragging, he said, "You know, if I'd have known Paul would have thrown a no-hitter, I'd have done so myself." One of my favorite stories about Dizzy Dean right there. If I know Paul would have done it, I would have done it myself. So anyway, all right, today's trivia question. Cool prize for you. 1977 Tops. Jim Cott, a new Hall of Famer. This is him on the Phillies. Always a fan of all kinds of people who ever played on the Phillies and ended up in the Hall of Fame. Jim Cott. That is your prize. 1977 Tops. Card of a Hall of Famer, Jim Cott. If you could answer me this simple question. What was the first baseball team to go by the name of their state rather than the city they played in? Now, do not tell me New York, because every team that used the name New York, it was referring to the city, never to the state. So don't tell me it was New York. Anyway, tell me the name of the first team to go by its state name instead of its city name. Shoot me an email. My email will be in the description below along with the repeat of that question. We will, you'll have today and tomorrow to answer. We will pick a winner on Sunday. So good luck to everybody on that. Great card up for grabs. So today a larger set Friday, and I want to show off a set that doesn't get a lot of credit, mostly because it's dang ugly. And like all card sets before and since, if it's a set that only shows the greats of the game post their playing careers, in other words, if it's a highlight set, a tribute set, it just doesn't have any value. And it saddens me because, well, I shouldn't say it saddens me that it doesn't have any value. It saddens me that people don't care about this set. Now, this set is fairly ugly in some of the cards that are included in it, but there's so much history in this card set and sets like it that I want to get more. You know, there's a couple other ones I would love to strive for, but haven't begun that journey yet. I like the Fleer cards of the early 60s. This is the 1989 Pacific. I'm going to show you a Series 1. There were two series in 1989. They had a Series 1 and a Series 2, and then they came out with another set in 1990. I have them all. They're very inexpensive, but the players included are unbelievable, and the history that they provide is second to none. You have Hank Aaron here, obviously in his Atlanta days. These are in numerical order here. Hall of Famer Red Shandis, second baseman for the St. Louis Cardinals. Great card of Brooks Robinson. You can see the look is very basic. There's not much to it. You just have like his best season listed plus career stats for whoever the players are. This is one of the reasons I think the set doesn't get a lot of appeal either. For whatever reason, there's a couple black and white era players that they put in there, and they just did like a really ugly looking colorization of the player. It's just terrible. This is Luke Appling, shortstop for the White Sox. Here you have players who aren't Hall of Famers who made huge contributions. Gene Woodling, longtime outfielder for the Yankees, played during their great years of the 50s. Stan Musial, obviously a legendary outfielder for the Cardinals. Mickey Mantle, I think it's cool that they put Mickey Mantle as card number 7 within that set. Richie Ashburn, I'm not going to show it to you, but in the 1990 set, they use the exact same picture of Richie Ashburn, which is another reason why the set doesn't get a lot of love. Interesting here, Ralph Kiner with the Indians, not the Pirates. I think that's really cool. You get players in uniforms you don't often see them in. There's Phil Rizzuto. Harvey Haddix on the Cardinals. Ken Boyer, Cardinals. and his brother Cleet Boyer. Love this one. Ken Hawk Harrelson on the Red Sox. Robin Roberts. This one makes me smile. Look how young Catfish Hunter is there. Here he is with the Oakland Athletics, but looking really young. Hondo, Frank Howard on the Dodgers. He was with many teams. Here's Gaylord's brother, Jim Perry. Elston Howard, catcher for the Yankees. Jim Boughton, already looking stoned out of his mind. Jim Boughton for the Yankees, who wrote that great ball book, Ball 4. Young-looking Pee-wee Reese, or maybe a veteran-looking Pee-wee Reese. Mel Stottlemyer. Hank Sawyer. Nice Willie Mays card with San Fran. Tommy Tresh. Roy Sievers. These are great, great players from baseball. Leo DeRoche, your Hall of Fame manager, says shortstop because it does talk about his career sometimes. Al Dark, classic shortstop. Tony Kubek. Here's another one. Johnny Vandermeer, one of those colorized cards that just looks so bad. Joe Adcock. Bob Lemon, Hall of Fame pitcher. Don Newcomb. Great Thurman Munson card. And again, these cards cover all eras of the game. That's why the other reason I love it to death. Ernie Banks, Matty Alou. I wish they had put a card of all three brothers right next to each other. Dave McNally, Mickey Lolich, star of the 68 World Series. Awesome Jackie Robinson card. Allie Reynolds, Super Chief. Don Larson, Fergie Jenkins. Jim Gilliam, retired number for the Dodgers. Bobby Thompson, Sparky, good Roy Campanella, Marv Throneberry, Bill Verdon. It's almost forget he ever played the game. Bill Verdon, Ted Williams, Minnie Minosa, newly minted Hall of Famer. Look at him there. Bob Turley, Yogi Berra on the Mets. Something you don't see too often. Yogi Berra on the Mets. Juan Marichal, Duke Snider. That's the first half of the set. I'm going to keep going through the whole set real quick. Harvey Kuhn with a big wad of chow, always in his cheek. Always had a big wad of chew on his cheek. Nelly Fox. Here's Felipe Alou. We just saw Matty earlier. There's Felipe. Tony Oliva, new Hall of Famer. Maz. Bobby Shantz. If you ever watch Ray from Philly's channel, Bobby Shantz is still living. Late 90s he is. Still active and spry a little bit. Still an active signer in the Philadelphia area. The Bird, Mark Fidrich. Another awful colorized card, Johnny Mize. Ralph Terry, pitcher, sitting down in the catcher's pose for some reason. Gus Bell. Love this Jerry Kuzman. Mike McCormick got a Cy Young 1 year. Lou Burdette finished off the 57 Braves World Championship for the Braves. George Kell, Hall of Famer. Vic Rashi. Here's a really cool one here. So this is Chuck Connors, the Rifleman, from the TV show, who played briefly with the Cubs. I think he played parts of two seasons. Don't quote me on that. It might have just been the one season, 51. He got into 66 games with the Cubs. He was actually signed by the Dodgers, but only played with the Cubs. And I don't know if they just didn't have a picture of him with the Cubs. I got to think somewhere out there there's a picture of him in his baseball uniform, but they did this art card instead. Klazuski, another awful color card. Bobby Doerr. Bobby Richardson, longtime Yankee great. Carl Oisken, longtime Dodger great. Hoyt Wilhelm, Hall of Famer. Bob Purkey. He's one of the few people in this set I don't think I've ever heard of. Bob Purkey. Don't know much about Bob Kirky. Bob Friend, great Pirates pitcher. Monty Irvin, Hall of Famer. Jim Lomborg, Red Sox and Phillies star. Wally Moon. Muscauron. Tommy Davis, great Dodger legend. Enos Slaughter, looking very old, Hall of Famer. Sal Magley, the barber. I remember him mostly for the Giants. Don't see him with as a Yankee. In other words, he's out of uniform to me. Harmon Killebrew. Here's another great one. Gil Hodges, Hall of Famer for the Brooklyn Dodgers, wearing a Washington Senators uniform. Those things are just fantastic. Jim Cott, Roger Maris, Billy Williams, Louis Aparicio, Jim Bunning with the Pirates, not the Tigers or the Phillies, but the Pirates, Bill Freehand, Orlando Cepeda on the Braves. Early win. Nice looking Tug McGraw card here. Ronnie Santo. Del Crandall. Sal Bando. Nice Joe DiMaggio. Good looking Joe there. Bob Feller. Larry Doby, Hall of Famer. Look at this one. Raleigh Fingers sans mustache. It looks like he's trying to grow it in there. I'm not sure if that's a shadow under his nose or if it's, you know what. But I think this is without the mustache. Al Kaline, nice collared shirt. Johnny Padres. Lou Boudreau, Hall of Famer. Zoilo Versalles, MVP 1 year, but not for the Dodgers. Dick Groat, Warren Spahn, and Johnny Bench. That is Series 1. Sorry, I'm knocking things around here. That is Series 1 of the Pacific. Like I said, they put out two more series, a second series in 1989 and a single series in 1990. I'm going to show off some of these other. I picked up a handful of cards out from the other sets I just wanted to show off. I love this card. Very young looking Tony La Russa on the Kansas City Athletics. And you thought that first Jim Hunter looked young. There's Jim right along with Tony, looking very young on the Kansas City Athletics. They threw in a Joe Jackson card in Series 2. It is Series 2. Joe Jackson. Again, it's a sketch card, though. Love this one. Joe Garagiola, who was a longtime announcer. People forget. He played for the Cardinals a couple years, and I think he actually won a World Series with them in the 40s. So this is a typo here. Oh, I picked up the wrong card. I'm going, wait a second. What happened to Joe Garagiola? I don't know. Let me flip it down there. And oh, there it is. Okay, this is from the 1990 series, Joe Garagiola. It says his best season was 52. I think he became a Hall of Fame, or not Hall of Fame. I think he won a World Series with the Cardinals, yeah. And then here's what I said before, the Richie Ashburn card was the exact same pose in the 1990 as it was for the 89. Love this card. If you know your Don Mossy card with the big ears, it wasn't a lie. The man has big ears. Just look at that. Look at the set on those, on this card here, Don Mossy. And this is one of my favorite cards. I told you before, they got a lot of these players in odd uniforms. Check out this Lou Piniella wearing the Seattle Pilots uniform. Absolutely fantastic. Now, again, these cards, each of the set would cost you between $10 and $20, depending upon where you picked it up off the bay. To get all three sets, then it would be somewhere between $30 and $60. I just think the history contained in these cards is so amazing sometimes to get pictures of some of the players in different uniforms, younger times. To have something you can hold in your hand and see these players when most of us are never going to have cards from the 50s or 60s. We're just not going to do it. I mean, I say that, but there's if you go to the common bins or the, there's that one table on every show somewhere where you got some guys got binders of every card from 52 through 70, and they're just selling them for like a couple bucks a pop. So yeah, you can get the cards of anybody you want probably, but I love those collections where it's a whole set and you can get them all at once for little to no money, because to me that's a beautiful thing. And I just wish more people appreciated sets of cards versus going for the slabbed valuable cards. But hey, we all have our collecting goals. We all have our niche. This is a hobby built for all, because everybody can do it their way. There's not one way to do this. So that is just something I wanted to show off. I think those sets are fantastic. Love that they're not a lot of money, and I have fun looking at them. So, hope you appreciated all of that today. Sorry I got long-winded, but I get passionate about star cards and sets. So, don't forget the trivia question. You can get that great Jim Cott card up there. And remember, I'll be picking a winner on Sunday, so stop back for that. Hope you guys from the National are settling down. Everybody out here in the Northeast, you've got the Philly show coming up in September. So, you know, start saving some money again for that, maybe. Maybe I'll see some of you guys all out there when that time comes, all right? Anyway, thanks for watching. I appreciate all the support. Please consider like, subscribing, commenting, and all that jazz. Stop back again Sunday. We'll do it again. Take care.